Welcome everyone to the Rabbit Mind YouTube channel, and we are in my bathroom, which is the home of this mosquito miner. Now, by mosquito miner, I mean the Jazzminer X41U. All these fans here do put out a high-pitched scream, which is why I do call this thing, and the little one also calls it the mosquito miner. So in this video, I am going to be changing out the control board in this. I already have it out. It's hanging out right here. This is the old control board, and the new one just came in. You can see this one's actually slightly different. It only has two of these plugs here. This goes to the ASIC chips itself, while this one has three. Everything else does look the same. I also see there is a little bit of damage on this right there. You can see it's pushed up, so hopefully this still works, but we'll find out once we put it in. So if you're unfamiliar with ASICs, usually they all, if they're the same brand, like these Jazzminers, we know the Q is coming out soon, the L3 Pluses, L3 Plus Plus, they all use the same control board, which is why they can be swapped out between each other. So this may be the same one the Q uses, utilizing both of these for pretty much twice the hash rate. But again, I can't confirm that because I don't know for a fact until we actually get to look at one of those Jazzminer Qs. Hopefully we will get the opportunity. I just want to do a quick rewind to confirm some stuff, because a lot of people do take things out of context. So no, these will not work on like an L3 or L3 Plus. I mean, control boards within the same type of miner. That's why I said the Antminer, L3 Pluses, L3 Plus Plus. Those control boards will work with each other. These are only for the Jazzminer. So I just want to clear that up before someone may try to mention that in the comments below. All right, so let's install this thing, but I want to let you guys all know what actually happened to this Jazzminer, just in case the issue happens to you. Maybe you may have the same issue. Now, mine is different than what everyone else's issue does seem to be. One is the ASIC chips and everything was working. It was doing all the get works. Everything was fine within the dashboard, but it was not displaying any fan RPM. The fans all said zero. And in the error log, it was actually telling me fan errors, whatever, RPM fan 10, RPM fan 20, whole bunch of fan errors. And then it'd last and last and it wouldn't do anything. So I let it run for a while, see if it would actually just begin mining on its own. And then all of a sudden, the middle ASIC chip kind of popped right here and smoked. You can kind of see the dot right there. And yeah, so this is 100% dead for sure. And now I hopefully, this one will work even with this little bit of error going on here. Where is it? Focus for me. Look at that. We can see that right there. That's probably bad. I don't know. Will this short something out if I put it in? You know what? I'm going to try it. I've been down for a while. FedEx is extremely slow at delivering anything. So I got to get this thing up and mine. I got to test the 5 GB DAG, see how this thing does, and if it can still mine Ethereum. This is the 520 mega hash version, so it should still be able to mine. I believe it's 5.2 memory as a total with 5 GB of working, which means it'll just run into the full total working of system memory and just have reduction of hash rates. Now, it's extremely efficient, so it should still be profitable while mining Ethereum. Again, I cannot confirm any of this until I get this thing working. All right, so I got the control board in place. I did not screw anything down because I do want to show you guys something first. I do believe you should plug these plugs in before you actually screw anything down in here, because it's going to be really hard to get at, as you can see here. So I would recommend plugging these in if you are doing a control board swap on your own while the control board is still out of the Jazzminer. And it's fairly easy to tell which one goes where. This LED is the short one. It goes right on the inside. This has a different plug here. It's a different LED. So actually, let me rewind here. This says J10. So J10 is on the inside. We got the LED, which is a totally separate plug going right beside your Ethernet port. And then we got J11 here, which is a longer wire, and it's going all the way to the far end. So pretty much it'll only work if you do it this way. So it's fairly easy not to mess up. But again, do it with the control board out of the Jazzminer itself. Once you get your control board in, there are only 4 screws, which you would have realized when you took this thing off, but they're tiny. So be very careful here. Will it focus? There, you can see it. So it has a washer, and inside of it on the inside, there's also a lock washer. So you're not gonna wanna lose these pieces. That keeps it from actually vibrating out once it's in place, because there are slow vibrations in here. So just remember that, be very careful not to lose any of these pieces. Also, leave them all loose until you get them all in, just in case you need to line up a hole slightly. All right, so I do have everything installed. We got our fan control cables here. We got our ASIC chips here. Power to our ASIC chips and then power to our control board. We still got the Ethernet cable, obviously, and to plug this thing in and then begin to see if this works. Now, I also want to point out the additional screws. The control board is the only one that uses the silver screws. Everything else on here does use these little black ones. They are interchangeable, whether it's these handles, it's the top of the case there, or that little wind tunnel thing. That wind tunnel goes on top here and it allows the air to flow across here in like a wind tunnel situation, straight through here and not escape out the top or anything, and then exhaust out the back fan. So all of those are interchangeable and use the black ones. You don't have to worry about them, but the four silver ones do go to your control board. All right, guys, so all that is left is to plug this thing in and hopefully it works. I got my meter box here. It finally came in. I got it all put together and we're gonna see how much power this thing uses. And then hopefully, you know, it, obviously it begins working. Now, if I have issues, I'm gonna come back. I'll try swapping the ASIC plug around to this one. Do everything you can at your own disposal before you go to tech support, because then, you know, pretty much don't just run out the tech because it could be something easy. Also, if you notice something, I do believe Chump Change out there had an issue with his, and he just banged it on the ground and, well, whatever he banged it on, but he banged it and said that, you know, all of a sudden it started working again. So I'm assuming in his case, it was just a loose connection. And if he has a loose connection, that could burn something out or start a fire. So Chump, if you're seeing this later on, take it apart, check your connections, make sure everything is tight. Crypto mining 101, GPUs, risers, anything. Small vibrations is always happening with anything you're using for mining. So something could slowly loosen on its own, and just make sure all your connections are tight. It's just a safety issue. All right, here goes nothing. Plugging it in right here. And we got fans, everything sounds normal and slow. I'm gonna jump to the workstation and hopefully we got RPMs on our fans. All right, guys, so we're just gonna have a quick look here. As it's idling, doing its get work thing, we're hanging out at about 45.6 watts here on the meter. We're at 119.2 volts. And then all this other gobbledygook, 0.41 amps. But yeah, 45.7 idling while it's kind of ramping this thing up. I'm pretty sure this thing is gonna work. It's doing everything it's supposed to now. It's reporting the RPM of the fan. So I'm gonna get it together all the way, and then hopefully by the time I'm done, it should only take a couple minutes, and then just wait for this thing to finally ramp up. All right, guys, before I did put this together, I did wanna give you a quick look of what it looks like if you just initially open the top. So here is that shroud I was kind of mentioning earlier. It just covers over top of the ASIC chips heatsink here. That big silver thing was the heatsink for all those ASIC chips inside here. And then this acts as a massive wind tunnel, blowing all the air underneath this and then exhausting out the back. So it does try to stay nice and cool on those ASIC chips. So I just wanted to point out how the interior of this works if you were to just open up the case directly. All right, guys, I'm at my workstation. I'm logged into the JazzMiner. Head to status here, and I'm not seeing anything yet. Refresh, refresh, refresh. Okay. It was mostly detected. It's not detecting right now. So we'll go to here, miner. There's not, we'll have, oh, it still has all my stuff saved. So that's good. Things so we're just going to put in US Flex Pool. Jazz Beast, yes. Password, nothing. Maybe X. I don't think we need a password for the Jazz Miner. Update. It's going to do its updating thing. And then hopefully this thing begins to work. I don't know. Status. Let's give it a couple of refreshes here. All right, so it just took a few refreshes. We are detected, the pool and everything updated, and I do see fans here at fan speed. So far, it is now working. So that's absolutely awesome. I just wanna go to the log. Are we getting any type of errors yet? It's not looking like num count, info good. Everything is looking good everywhere. So yes, the little bit of damage on that control board seems to be not an issue, as well as just JazzMiner is now running. So it was 100% a control board issue. Now what's going on here? Why is it? Never mind, it's there again. One thing we got to check here also, firmware, April 24th. I do believe July is the latest. So yeah, 2022 07 28. So yeah, July 28th is the latest. So this is on
earlier firmware. So I am going to update the firmware here, and then, you know, we'll look in to see what kind of power consumption and everything. Maybe this control board is an awesome deal. You might want to swap yours out. I don't know. We'll find out. So I always do try to keep my website up to date. You can just come into here, rabbitmining.com, find out crypto mining hardware here, let it load, go to ASICs. And I do have the iPolos as well as the latest Jazzminer firmware. Here we can see our latest Jazzminer X41U. It's the July 28th version. And iPolo, I still have to update this. I have heard, thank you to T-Swift, there is a new version of iPolo firmware, which I am going to update this website. So at the time of watching this video, it should have the latest update here for all those iPolo mini miners. That's the ETC mini, your ETC mini plus, as well as the ETH miner, which is your gold one. So that works for all of these little mini miners. So here's the firmware for it. I'm going to update and see what happens. To update the firmware yourself, you simply come down to upgrade, select the firmware, the whole tar file. You don't need to extract or anything. Put the whole thing in there, hit open, and then upload image. Yes, I want to confirm the upgrade, and then just wait it out and it should upgrade for you. All right, so it only took about 30-35 seconds and it says upgrade is finished. We're gonna hit okay here, come back into status, see if we have to put in. Looks like it kept all our same settings. Oh, there's one thing I do want to do here I forgot about. So when we're coming in, where is status overview? Where is it? I want to adjust the overclocks here. We need to overclock this thing, wrap it right up. We need to power out the hash as much as we possibly can. And I was blind, it's on ETC, so we got to swap that. The ETH 200, we're going 225 megahertz. Now allegedly you can edit the HTML file and get 250 out of this. This is already getting close to, what is it, 295, 296 watts, 286, depending how it's running, depending on fan and heat. So we're getting close. It's a power supply of only 300 watts, so going even more could ruin your ASIC chips as well as start overloading your power supply. So keep that in mind. And I don't know if that's a for sure thing, it's just a rumor, but allegedly it's possible to overclock even further than what it's saying. All right, so I am all set here. We got ETH at Flexpool, got my address, it's named the Jazz Beast. We got 225 megahertz on Ethereum. We're gonna go status here, and now it's doing its thing again. You know, it's doing its reboot thing. It's okay, guys, this is normal, don't start freaking out. We're gonna let this thing wrap up. I'll figure out how long it takes, if it's faster, slower, you know, anything different with this new control board or not, and we'll take it from there, as well as see if this thing is still mining with the 5 gigabyte DAG hitting Ethereum. It should still work. Okay, so I'm right at the 34:54 second mark, and I was refreshing this since about the 33 minute mark, and finally it found one share. So I think it took like an extra 20 seconds, obviously plus or minus. Every time it restarts, it'll be slightly different, but it is now mining Ethereum. It found a share at the 34 minute and 54 second mark. It's gonna hit refresh. Hash rate is starting to start here. 8 accepted shares, so fans are picking up a bit. Awesome. I'm going to let this run for a while, and we'll see just how well this thing is actually mining. But so far, control board is working. The Jazz Miner is working. We're finding shares. Everything is looking 100% at this point. It just comes down to how much hash rate have we lost due to that 5 gigabyte DAG size. The pool here did detect the Jazz Miner, so yes, everything is working as intended. Now we do have to wait 24 hours to actually get an accurate calculation on how this thing is mining. So I will do an update 5 gigabyte Jazz Miner video in a few days here and decide, you know, should we keep this on Ethereum? Should we move it to ETC and just see where we could pick up the most amount of profits before the merge goes through? All right, guys, so we're hanging in at about the 298.5.6 watts here. It's fairly stable. Just before I came, the fans are hanging in at a cool 16,000 RPM, you know, hashing away like a mosquito, so it is fairly loud. You can most likely hear it at this point. It's been going for about 7 or 8 hours. At the 6 hour average, we're hanging in at about 484 mega hash. So we're about 100 less. Again, I will not know the full numbers until that full 24 hours goes by, and I will update this video sometime then. Also, we do have a DAG file at the time of this video appearing. 2 days time will increase the DAG size a little bit more. The epoch will go up, and then all your Jazz Miners will reset.
and load that DAG once again, and we may lose a little bit of more hash rate. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching this video. The Jazz Miner is up and mining once again. I'll see you on the next one. Rabbit out.